All right, so in half an hour, we'll cover the topic which we have covered in the first session, email marketing. And then after this half an hour, we'll cover the regular session today. Others will also join us, I guess, by then. I'll go with the practical one because we only have half an hour, but just give you 2-3 minutes, a brief introduction on email marketing. It's basically putting an email as a message into your inbox directly. Into your inbox means to the customers import or the prospective customers which you want them to buy from your brand or whatever brand you're working as a manager for. There are two types of email marketing, promotional and transactional. Promotional is basically like this. Transactional is basically like this. For example, we may have used free charge or any other such site for recharging a phone, and then we got the information, or you may have booked the online ticket, a movie ticket, through any portal, either directly from the multiplex or let's say from Book My Show and all that. And what you get in return in email is the transactional message that this is the ticket which you have bought, this is the detail, this is the invoice and all that. Now this is working as transactional email, and when you get a message like this, it's a promotional email where you being targeted as the prospective customer, and you have been introduced with one or the other merchandise or any other product or service which the brand is offering. Anil is saying your voice is breaking. Rajiv, are you able to listen to me? Anil, is it clear now? All right, Anil, now it is better. Right, now this is then it has been referred to as promotional email. Are we clear till here? What is promotional email and what is transactional email? All right. Now quickly we can touch the four main points: why email marketing, what are the advantages of it, why it is important, and is it advantages as compared to the other promotional channels like social media marketing or YouTube marketing, which you covered last. First, email marketing give you a continual effect. I mean, once you know the details of the customer and subscribe to your newsletter or email service, whatever you are offering, then you get a chance to continuously interact. But you have to just keep in mind that you should not overdo it. Excess of everything is bad. If I'm regularly getting messages from one portal, I may ignore it because I'm getting tons of messages anyways in my inbox as a promotional SMS. So you have to be a little creative in how to draft it, what taglines to use, what subject line to use to keep it interactive, and try to solve the issue as specific as possible. This is what my suggestion towards using email marketing will be. Windows to let you know more. Then it also works as a special purpose vehicle. I've given the example in the last session, I'll repeat it. Like for example, when Big Billion Day last year happened, not this year, but the last year, it was the first time they have offered this Big Billion Day Flipkart. And they were offering a heavy discount on that day. But they haven't expected the load to that much, which it eventually ended up with. And it basically crashed down. The website crashed down, or it was not able to give them a full service. Like for example, few customers had the items on cart but unable to purchase it. Few unable to buy it, but the product were not delivered on time. And there were many goof ups. The site was down. People were not able to open it and access it and all that. Now this happened because you are not able, you have prepared enough, but since you are not prepared enough to expect the footfall and service it properly. Now what happened is, on the next day, the top management, including Sachin Bansal, wrote an email and sent it to all their customers, which are in millions. So, or whatever database they have as a registered customer of Flipkart, and they have offered an apology through one email. Now imagine that to do with any other functionality, it is very difficult. So you can use it as a special purpose vehicle also. Sometimes you require to shoot a emotional email to all, and you can just do it by writing one email and just shooting it at one go and catering to n number of customers. So even that, so we'll be using one portal through which we'll be sending emails. Now we can send these emails to n. N means specifically, and you can just put on any data and you can just you can send it to n number of customers at one go. You can also design this, like for example, let's say Snapdeal or any other e-commerce site. They have different categories of product they are offering. Now, if your brand has different categories of products it is offering, I may like to choose Rajiv for promoting shoes because my research may say that Rajiv is more inclined towards buying shoe compared to Anil, who is more inclined towards buying, let's say, shades, goggles and all that. So I may include you in the list of shoes for Rajiv and in the list of goggles, Anil, I may include him. And then I can draft different emails and send differently. So I can customize it. I can choose the audience according to their taste and send it. So that is the advantage which I get. So I may not bore Rajiv with jackets and sunglasses. I may not bore Anil with shoes. So I can just separate them with promoting my brand. So that's the advantage which I get, right? Are we clear till here? Rajiv Anil, are we clear? That sometimes it may go wrong if you do not use it properly. You sometimes forward a link with a different image and you may have put a different backend link to a different page. Like for example, I'll try to show you through an example. And then you'll be clear. There are few service providers who gives you service to offer these, make the promotional emails and send it across, and we'll run how to do that today, right? So one of them is MailChimp, which is highly recommendable and very, very good to use and easy to use as well. You have to make an account in email MailChimp like any other sign up you do in any other portal. The same way, once you do that, you come up to this dashboard page. But here, since you are promoting an email, promotional email service, so you have to register, put the inputs of your company as well. So as an individual basis, of course, you may not require to put a promotional email. So you must be doing it on the behalf of a company. So you have to put your name and details as well as the company name and details into it. So like for example, I'm using my company name to win Dreams E-commerce Private Limited, and the same you can do it. Once you're registered to it, you can you have to start it. First, you should go with creating a list. List as in to all the subscribers you want to add into it. Where you want to send to. You can click into create list. Go in creating a list. And you can name it. Let's name it DMP new list, right? You can name anything what you like. Hi Preeti, hi Mukesh. We are covering for half an hour. We're covering email marketing, which for all those who have missed it on the first session, and then at 8:30 we'll start Facebook session, which is our regular session today. Yeah. There you can give your marketing ID, the ID from which you wanted to sell. Send it. Default from name is your brand name. You can use it anything, like for example, let me use it Romania. And these are the details which will fit from the details which you have put in to at the time of registration. And then you can if in case you want a daily summary, you can just click on that and go to save. And it will ask you, I guess there is something which I missed. Okay. See, this service provider or any other service provider would not allow you to drop an email to anyone because it will hinder their privacy, right? So in order to have that, to all those prospective customers or customers where we want our message to be sent should have subscribed to your offering somewhere or the other. And that's why they keep on asking you in the activity of sending an email, they keep on asking you at different places that how you came to know about this customer and all that. So they want reassurance. And if they found that people are unsubscribing into it or reporting abuse against you, since they are not subscribed to it and you're just sending it across, they will debar your account to be used into their portal, right? So you have to just be careful about it because it's against the cyber laws. Let's say, for example, you can just try that you're receiving it because you have subscribed to this offer. Right? Yeah, Rajiv, I'll answer you. Let me just complete this step. Let me complete this mechanical thing and then I'll get back to you. Let us complete the list and then I'll answer you. Now once you do that, name the listing and all that, you will go to adding subscribers. You can add subscriber one by one or you can import a CSV file, which is an extension of further extension of this Excel sheet. So you can just note down the list, the email IDs on an Excel sheet and just convert it into CSV file and then import it here. We'll try to do it one by one. Rajiv and Anil, may I know your email IDs, please? And Preeti, also yours. I've received Rajiv's email ID, so first name Rajiv, last name Kumar. So this person have given me the permission to email them. I have to check it on. I have to click subscribe. I received Preeti's or email ID now. I'm putting Preeti's details over here. So first name is Preeti. So I'm only picking 2-3 IDs right now. Because it will take a lot of time to put all the email IDs which are there currently. And I'm taking Anil's ID as well. So you can create the list as long as possible. Once you will be running practical campaigns, one by one will not be feasible. Anil, your last name, please. And then you subscribe it, right? So your list is complete now. And then you're going ahead with creating campaigns. So just go to campaign and you go on creating a new campaign. So you go over there on a create campaign and click on regular campaign, and now it will be a five-step process. On first, you can look onto the bottom of the screen. It will ask you to put the recipient, the list from to the email ID where you want to send it. You can pick the list to which you can send. So you can make different lists to your account and then pick it up. Then there will be a setup stage, then design template and designing stage. So we'll do one by one. First, we have to pick the recipients. So we are picking this list which we have created now, and we are sending it to the entire list. Then next. See, what you're going to be learning today will be a mechanical way of doing it. You'll understand where to click, how to create an email ID, but you'll get hands-on only when you practice it. So I request you to just practice it enough and use it. Name your campaign. So you can name anything. What do you want to name? Let's say New Year campaign. Or let's only name New Year. Email subject. So for example, you are offering passes for New Year party. So you can just write down free passes. One year Eve. So your email should be attractive. Now that comes as a part of how creatively you're doing it. Rajiv, I remember your question. I'll answer that in the once we're done with this mechanical thing, and then you go to the next. And you now here is the part of choosing the template, and the next one is designing it all. So we have to choose according to our wish what template suits you best in designing. Let's say we picked up this. And here it comes in different modules. There are different modules to this. Let's, for example, we do not want this module. Yeah, overhead gives us near, so we can delete it. And we want an image over there, and we have already created an image. So we'll browse that. I was working few of my clients which are into movie business. So last time I've given an example of Dilwale. Anyways, I was making that campaign. So let us also pick that for our urgency purpose. Let's pick this up. Let's select it. So it will come over here. Whatever image. So you already have made your creative, and you just need to browse it and paste it over here. And here, let's say you want to edit it. So if you click over here on the right hand side, you will get the chance to edit it. And let's say you are putting over here is free passes on New Year Eve. Or let's, and you're saying Vamania is off. You can just write down any text you want, offering you free passes. Please check out these click on the home image to await your offer. Right? So this way you write down the text. And let's say, for example, I do not want this image, I want to replace it. So I can just go over there and replace it. Let's say, for example, I'm replacing it with this gift voucher or image. Should be replaced with this. Now what I've written over here is on the email when it will be dropped to the subscribers, It will come as free passes on New Year's Eve. Woman is offering this. Please click on the above image. That means this image. But how can I put the link over there? So what I can do is I can just click over there on the right hand side. I am getting the windows to edit it, and there is a button called link. I have to click that on link, and I have to put down the landing page address. That landing page address could be another page into your website. So for example, you can just put any address over here. I was using Orienta, so let me put Orienta. Or I'm just picking the landing page from here. Orienta Cine. Let's say this is the landing page. So I'll just put the landing page address over here and insert it. And I can also go over here and Sanobar, webcam is not required, so you can just log off your webcam and you can communicate with me on the chat. Anyways, coming back to it, now here I can put the Twitter addresses, Facebook addresses, all my brand's landing pages for social media as well as Twitter and all that, and my website link over here. So I can just go over here and write, you know, copy paste my Twitter's address and my YouTube channel or whatever I want to do that. So I can just, I'm not using it right now because we have very less time left, but you can click do it over here and then you save and close. This is, we are doing a rework. We already have covered email marketing onto the first session. A 2-hour session, we are just crunching it onto the half an hour for all those who have missed it. But we'll do a regular session today. We'll start at 8:30 or around at 8:30, 8:35, and we'll cover email marketing today. Anyways, this is how you're going to do it. And this will anyways be coming the last part by default. And this is your, let's understand that, for example, this is how you designed it, your email marketing to go. And you just go to next. And it'll ask for your confirmation. You can also schedule it. Clicking on pre-schedule, you can just, sitting on today, you can make a campaign on for 31st. You can make a campaign on any date in the future. So it is not that one, when you have to send it, then only you have to do it. You can just pre-do it and keep on, select the clock, the date and the time, and it will be sent automatically. We are right now doing it right now because it to test it out. So we're clicking on send. So it is saying that, okay, we are prepared to launch. Once you click, it will be sent. And I've clicked on the send now. And Anil, Preeti, and Rajiv, can you guys just confirm, have you received the email? Hi everyone. We are just finishing it off with our email marketing. For all those who have missed onto the first session when we have done this, we will be covering Facebook, and we're going to start the regular session for today in 5 more minutes. Alright, so you can just check it out. You can check out the link as well. Good. So this is how you do it. And now coming to your question, how do you know approach or make a list of, yeah, hi. How do you make a list of potential customers is basically going with different, but this question we have covered in detail on the last session also. You can do it by promoting it onto the different channels and try them to subscribe it. You can create a mandatory page once somebody logs into your website, if in case it's your online business and all that, and there are people who are frequently required to avail the service onto your website. So you can put a newsletter kind of option over there and somebody can click that. You have to try all the means possible into your list. There are people who are offering you with data also into the market, but that is not suggested from me, A, because this is not purely legal way to going about it and bombarding emails on to people who have not subscribed to you. So go it organically. Try to approach different websites personally, and you know, try to include your term into the policy, into their terms and condition policy once they log in for newsletters onto their customers. So what you can do is, for example, mine is womania.com, let's say, and yours is, let's say, goggles.com, for example, and you are offering goggles. So you can approach womania.com and say, why don't you include into your terms and conditions, once somebody registered you for the subscribe, that you and me are the partner sites, and you are, if you are offering me, allowing me to give the subscriber, simultaneously also doing for all your partner sites, which will include your site as well. So you will basically can work out a little barter with them and give your database to them, which will be a legal bond in that case. And then, so ultimately you should have an some authentication that the end consumer has subscribed to you. Nobody go in deep to read the terms and condition. Now, this is not illegal. This is in marketing language. Honestly, guys, this is called ambush marketing. So this is a part of the module. This is how the trade happens. All right. So these are the possible ways you have to go about it. Any other question? And are we clear with email marketing for all those who have missed on the first session? So if I'm going email marketing for a client, then I can ask the client itself to provide me database. Yes. Yes, of course, client will offer you the email. I'm assuming that right now you are asking question, like, for example, you are working on the behalf of any client and you are an agency who is taking care for this social media practices, marketing, and you have been asked to do an email marketing for them. And this brand, you are saying that they should provide you the list. Of course, they should provide you that. This should be on the first checklist when you work with any brand, any client. So they give you the database because they anyways going to have that. Somebody who have, let's say, for example, a retail offline business will have a good database with them. So they will provide you. And another thing I'll request you is, Rajiv and all others, since you have put this question, putting yourself under the camouflage of an agency and you're working for the third party, which is the end client, which is the end brand for which you're doing it, just create a different account into the MailChimp or any service which you're taking it up for them. Do not use your master ID thing from your account. So create a separate account, create a separate classification, because you anyways have to put all the details. You'll just be handling it. So even if the data which they have provided is turns out to be a false data and people keep on unsubscribe it, you will not get a loss to your main business. So keep it separately for all the clients you are doing it. That may be a little tedious. You may have many clients and you need to create many accounts and you have to log in differently at every time. But then this is long-term thing and you should be doing it. Yeah. So, are we clear, Rajiv and all of this? Yeah. So any other question on email marketing, anyone can ask me, even if they have done the first session, doesn't mind. So anyways, friends, have you, for all those who have covered it, have you practiced it in a dry run? Aapne logo ne email marketing kara hai, practice? Well, you have to do it. I haven't received, any email marketing, I've asked you to include me into the list, but I'm undeceived. I've got one call from someone that he has sent that, but I'm sorry, even I have not received that also, right? Anyways, Anto is asking one question to send to simultaneously for more than 500 or more. You can, Anto, create this list of n number of people. So you can just create an n, like for example in MailChimp, you can include n IDs. So it doesn't matter 500 or 5000, you can just create n. Like for example, MailChimp or any other service provider, of course, while you're using their free plan, they will limit you to few email IDs. But if you've taken a paid offering, you'll be allowed to put any email IDs. Chirag, hello, I just joined the session. Yeah, hi Chirag. Yes, it is Facebook session and we are just going to start in 2-3 minutes. From last and half an hour, we were covering email marketing. We have anyways covered email marketing earlier. That was for all those students who have missed it on the first session when we have covered Chirag. So we are covering Facebook today, a full regular session on Facebook. So Pri requested to send me last two session recording videos. Yes, last for every recording video, I'll just share you the wait. Anyways, I'm going to start the session and this email thing, this recording videos also, I'll share you the link where you can avail all the videos. Friends, this is the link. I'm just sending it across on the chat. Chirag, I'll answer you. First, I'm sending you this link. You can just, all of you can log into this link. For all those who have anyways already subscribed to the course, will be able to avail all the videos, including the one we are discussing right now in a day's time, and all the earlier videos. And for all those who have not subscribed, are running on a demo right now, will be able to have a limited access into it. So anyway, this is the link where you can access all the videos. All right. Chirag is saying, okay, sir, I missed the email marketing this time also. Please send me a recorded session. This is the link which I've sent, Chirag. You can just go to this link and check it out, the video itself over there. It'll have all the videos, including this. Okay. Aline is saying, this is my demo lecture. What are we covering? Haleen will be covering Facebook marketing today, a part of social media. On the first session of this batch, we have covered email marketing. On the second session, we have covered YouTube promotions. And on third session, we are covering Facebook marketing today. Now, personally, I believe that these are the three different aspects which you should, as a batch, should be covering initially, rather than going on to the website making and a monotonous and orthodox way of learning. The reason behind this is, once you know this, you have hands grip to email marketing. You'll get the taste social media, digital marketing, and you get the taste of using it onto the different bits. You have covered email promotions, which is quite objective in nature. You have covered YouTube promotions, because I strongly believe 5 years to 10 years down the line, you'll have a very, very good diminishing rate of keyword search based promotions into digital marketing. It will be a changed world. You'll be doing more of video promotions, because that is more attractive. This is not that attractive. Google is anyways, just to share the information, I've shared it on the last for all those guys who joined it for the first time. Google India's this year revenue was only 4,400 crore, which is a way less than expected from Google, and the main domination was towards the keyword base, and this is again going at a diminishing return. So yeah, and I'll go so this is the reason will be we have covered YouTube on the last session, we have covered email marketing, and today we are covering the more subjective nature, the social media promotion, and Facebook is right now the biggest into it, so we're covering Facebook today. Right, so let us start the session. All right, Chitranshi and everybody else, I've already shared the link. Yes, the last session video was not uploaded, it was missed, but I guess it will be uploaded today onto the link which I've already shared with you, right? Yeah, so you can avail all the links over there. All right, now let's say email marketing is, or keyword search promotion in digital marketing or in any marketing aspect is more objective, it's more precise. Like for example, you go with sunglasses, or you want to buy sunglasses in a range of 500 to 5000 rupees, and you put it onto the Google search bar, and it gives you the result which include your keyword promotion result as a brand manager. You'll see that it is more objective, but then there are more subjective to it. Like any other print ad or any other video ad, Facebook gives you an offer where a Facebook user has committed for its practice, but onto the right hand side can also look onto the various promotions going on which can attract his interest or her interest and work as a stimuli like any print ad or any other good ad you see on a TV works. So that is more subjective. Why I'm saying more subjective, because once we see down during the course when we do a practical run, this session today is divided into two halves. On the first half, we'll try to cover the aspect of Facebook, and on the latter half, we'll run a dry run. We'll put an ad into the Facebook promotions and we'll run a step-by-step process of how to launch a Facebook campaign and a Facebook ad like we have done in YouTube, so you'll understand completely. Supreet, am I, everybody else, is the connection still on? Are you guys able to listen to me? Because Supreet unfortunately is not. Supreet, it may have been yes, so I'm very much audible at different places. So for all those who have not done, try to wait. Maybe now you will be able to. Supreet, is it okay now? And Anil? Yeah, because it's fine from my side. Is the connection again set up, Supreet? Is it okay now? I think Anil is also getting nice now. All right, Ashalata is saying yes. All right, Preeti and all that. All right. So this is what I was saying. So it's little subjective in nature, but it gives you an idea. Once we go into the practical run on the later of this session, you'll see that once you choose a campaign or an ad, you have to choose amongst the different alternative, amongst the different objectives it has. And it has 10 to 12 objectives. So why I'm saying subjective, because your objective behind putting a campaign can be your brand's Facebook page like, or it can be asking them to come into your website, you know, prompting them to come into your website, or it can be only a post boost, or it can be an end conversion also. So there are different objectives and different subjective in nature. Right, and one more thing which all you should remember, I'm repeating it what I've repeated on the first session, digital marketing doesn't work in isolation. Digital marketing is a baby of marketing, and since it's a baby of marketing, it have all the genes and all the practices what is used in marketing. And in marketing, the first aspect is that you have to create an aura that people get prompted to do certain action, and that certain action depends on the objective of the campaign, of the ad. You may want them to ultimately buy it, and in certain cases you may not ultimately want them to buy it. Kesh is also not able to hear me. I think Mukesh is re-logging again probably and trying it. And I guess I'm, since audible to all, it is fine from here. So let's continue with the session. So what I was saying is, since you will be using different objectives, it's the putting an ad doesn't always have the objective of having an ultimate sale into your website, if in case it's an e-commerce website or any other business also. It depends on the of different stage of the business you are in. If it's a very, very new business, of course you require a good number of transactions to have the cash flow in. But from the marketing point of view, your first idea is to create as many good client base into you, a good brand equity into you. And that is your main objective. So you concentrate over there more. So you're like, for example, for new brands, what I suggest always is, if you're using Facebook marketing, do not try to ultimately put the, because there are various objectives. One of the objectives is to have the ultimate conversion. So if there is an ad shown into the Facebook and somebody clicks onto that, will land to your landing page of your, let's say for example, e-commerce website, and lands to the ultimate page. And if it clicks on buy now and buys it, then you'll get it onto the dashboard of your ads manager in Facebook, and you came to know that it has ultimately converted it. So they try to make the ad in, frame the ad in such a way and push to all those customers in their database, in the Facebook database, in client base, where they eventually have the high tendency of converting it. Now that is one way, one objective. The other objective out of those 12 objectives is that you want to do a page like. So if it's a B2B, B2C business and an e-commerce business, Ashrat, I'll answer you that. First, I'll complete what I was trying to say. And since yours is also e-commerce site, could help this point. That if you're doing an e-commerce business, a very new site, and you're going on the aspirational ground and all that, you would want a good database. You want good fan base into your Facebook. So I'll suggest not to pick the final conversion or the website conversion objective into Facebook. Try to make as many likes as possible into your Facebook page. Now, if I am a third person into Facebook and I check out your Facebook brand's Facebook page. No, Mukesh, when you left, we haven't moved across. We are discussing on the same point. And earlier, it was not, you haven't lost it too much. Don't worry. Listen to this point. This is a very critical point. So if you do that, I suggest you, for a new brand, for a new B2C brand specifically, I suggest you to put a more number of page likes concentration for at least first 3 months or 4 months. And once you have a good number to back up, every client may visit your Facebook page and see there are thousands and thousands of likes into it. So what is my perception? That is a good brand. Yeah, people are liking it. There's such a big fan base over there. And I get prompted to buy from you. Rather than just putting a different product into a common product like all others are offering and then asking me to buy it. I won't buy it. I'd rather buy it from Flipkart than you, right? Ashalata has asked a question. Anyways, are we clear till here? In the meanwhile, I'm just reading the question and answering that. Preeti, Rishikant, Sanobar, are we clear? Can you discuss how one decides a platform over the, of how to divide the purchase on different platforms? Yes, we'll go to the next slide, and then we'll try to cover why and how to choose the social media. And once I'll be covering that, Ashalata, I'll try to cover the whole question which I have asked.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, Supreet, I guess you are speaking.
Hello.
Supreet, I guess you are speaking something on the mic. Why don't you just write down on the chat window? I'm muting all you guys, and we are using as a protocol that you should. All right, sorry, Supreet. There was someone else, but. Please write down the question onto the chat window. Mukesh is saying, all right, Mukesh, is it okay? You haven't missed much. Three sites was anyways the link sharing site, so it was not a matter as such. Right. Friends, are we clear till here? Rishikant, Supreet, Arlene, Chirag, Ashalata, yeah. All right. Now that was my. Anyways, we are on the question which is closely onto the slide, which is closely related to the question Ashalata has asked. How do you choose when to start which part of the digital marketing into your full campaign, and how do you decide the budget over it? What is the choice of using which or the other? See, there is no fixed answer to that, and whosoever says that there is a fixed pattern, you just read on to this pattern, is making a false statement. Ashalata, since you asked this question, I'm taking you as a metaphor and example over here. When you were a kid, when you were like 5 years or 6 year old, what was your immediate choice? What is something which prompted you? Must be chocolates, cookies and all that, right? Then you come into the teenage, your immediate attraction become towards the fashion oriented products, like for example good apparels, good beauty products, talking to boys and all that. That becomes, for me, it becomes talking to girls when I was around 15-16. Then your priority changes once you come into the 23-24. You become more serious toward the business and all that, or whatever subject you're pursuing. Then you come into the 30, family comes into the picture. This is a general trend of how individual behavior changes. At a different stage of life, you have different priorities, you have different spending patterns, you have different interests, and you require different objectives. The same goes with the brand. So first you have to understand what type of brand you are, and that at what stage of business you are in. Then only you will be able to determine what as a digital marketer you have to choose. Like for example, if I'm a fashion oriented e-commerce or fashion oriented blog writing writer or fashion oriented thing, then I have to use more imaginary functions. It is no point in starting an email campaign on the first date. A, you will not have the subscriber list with you.
Hello. You,
yes, somebody saying hello. Can you please write down whatever question of yours is rather than speaking on the mic? Yeah. So if you are a fashion-oriented e-commerce or blog writing site, I was saying, as an example, there is no point in picking up and email marketing as the first go. First, you should concentrate of shaping your product well. So you have to concentrate on a good visual oriented, attractive colors, attractive combinations onto the website. That is your first product. The second is you should go with the social media. This is my belief, because and it will be a slow run. It will be a food cook on a slow stove, but it will be for a long run. It may give you a little time to fetch the transactions onto the site, but it will be more useful. So try to create a good Facebook page. Try to put regular posts into it. Try to create as many as fan base as possible onto all the social media, including Twitter, including Facebook, including WhatsApp nowadays. and try to channelize it, try to create a brand aura around it, then move to the transactionally possible things. Go with the keyword search, as if in case you want to do that, onto the Google and all that, because Google will suck away all your budget and will return you a very less ROI. Their ROI is not your ROI. Your ROI is the end transaction, if in case you have that business. So you may land up paying it 25 rupees, 20 rupees, 18 rupees, because if you are in common business of, let's say, real estate, travel, or fashion oriented products, your keyword cost will be very high. And since you're doing it on a search, keyword search ad, you have to understand that if I want to buy something, I'll keep on searching it, and I'll search 10 at 10 different places, and then I'll look to buy it. And I would not look to, I mean, it will take a longer gestation to buy it. Whereas once it gets onto the visual mediums of social media, where you can appeal it somehow, then the database, the fan loyalty base is much more higher. So I'll rather not concentrate on Google. I'll rather concentrate on social media over it onto the next stage. If in case I want to use Google's part, I'll try to use YouTube and not the keyword search. Because again, I'm saying you will be exhausted with a lot of your budget. And once you have a good database, then people will go on doing it onto the different modes of, you know, keyword search and all that. So go try to do the organic thing. Try to do the SEO in the starting rather than going for the Google AdWords, a keyword based search. So this is the hierarchy which I'll follow if I'll be a fashion oriented new site, an e-commerce or a blogging site. But the rules changes once you are an established player, you already are into the business for 2 years, then you may not try to do it more of a Facebook, you'll try to concentrate more on a Google keyword search, because there you have enough budget into your marketing kitty to beat the competition out of hell. If I am now a today's PATM, which I was not even existing 2-3 years back, I can compete with mighty guys like Flipkart, Amazon and all that. So it depends, right? So are we getting the answer? And if in case you still have doubt, can just put a specific brand or category, and then we can discuss it over as a case study. But are we clear? Are we generally clear of how to do it? Achalata, Mukesh, Chirag, Harleen, Naveen, yeah. For mattresses, but you will be selling your own mattresses, or you will be a marketplace, or you are a seller on any other marketplace. Who are you? No, that's okay. I mean, I'm asking Chirag, like, for example, if you are promoting mattresses, you also have to understand what type of business you are in terms of selling market mattresses. You can be a seller who have purchased the mattresses and selling it on Flipkart. You can have your own site where you are only selling your mattresses. Or you are a marketplace of mattresses where you are inviting different sellers to come, and you will only do the communication part, like what Flipkart and this thing done. So this also depends, because if you are a marketplace, then you have to show a good results in the starting to the seller. So then you may have to drop down a little bit on social media and try to do the things which can give you immediate transaction, like keyword, Google AdWords and all that. But if you are an own sell kind of thing and you have a better margin to play, like for example, if you are selling a mattresses at 7,999, and with selling only one mattress, you'll maybe able to kitty around 60 to 70% or 30 to 40% of the margin money, then you're getting good monies to back it up. So you can go on a slow burner. If you go on a slow burner, try to use the fan base methodology in digital marketing. Try to do a little bit of Facebook rather than Google keyword searches. Make a good YouTube ad and try to promote it. Do that in that case. Of course, go organically with SEO, make a good website, try to get more and more email IDs from promoting it onto different channels, asking them to subscribe you and using it. Yeah, if you are just a communicator, I won't take much of time. We are deviating from the subject for long. But I'll try to answer Chirag and then I'll try to move forward. If you're just like Flipkart, your immediate concentration becomes towards getting a good sale. Because in mattresses, I do not think that Flipkart should have been offering anything more than 7 to 8%. So this will be the general trend it was saying. So if you are a marketplace, the exact word in the digital marketing technology, Chirag, for the communicator between seller and buyer is marketplace. So you should use the word marketplace from now on. Marketplace, if you are a marketplace, then you have a very thin margin to go about it. So try to keep the infrastructure very lean and try to concentrate more on Google AdWords on a key base and on the shopping module. Do you know what is shopping module? All right, this will be covered in a topic in detail, but I'm just giving an example. Wanna buy mattresses. See, once I've written buy mattresses and I'm the end consumer who's looking to buy it, this what I'm saying is out of Google's kitty, Google AdWords, this is keyword search ad and everybody can look into it. Whosoever have missed in the earlier session. So, and this is organic listing. So this is the result of SEO where the ad is not written. And on the right hand side, you can see that you can see the image, you can see the price, you can see the service provider who is offering pepper fry. So if you're pepper fry Chirag, you can rather in the starting, do not concentrate over here, over this. Concentrate over here. Because you'll get a full window of putting an image, putting a price and all that. So try to do these ads so that people get attracted towards it and directly goes towards buying it. Are we? Oh, all right. So we're getting it. Anyways, let's come back to the topic. And this is what I want to say, that where you want to study social media. According to me, in most of the new or earlier stage startups, the first should be digital media. Now, this is my belief because digital media give you a database for email marketing. Digital media will give you a good perception building. Digital marketing, social media will give you a good one-on-one interaction. You can place on various offers, go down various contests so that it becomes two-way communication. If I run the contest on behalf of as a brand manager and the end consumer get involved into it, so it becomes an involving strategy and I get a chance to communicate with the brand team as a customer. So for me, social media actually comes first rather than all the other channels. Right. Ashalata, have you got the answer what you were asking? And are we anyways getting Naveen, Preeti, Sarabjit, Harleen, Chitranshi? Yeah, so everything clear till here? So this is what I was saying. No doubt it will give you a good fan base. And Facebook promotion is a very, very dominant part of social media. And into social media, the fundamental rule of consumerism plays more. When all of you do any business, or you are manager for any other brand, working as an employee into any department, try to remember one thing into business. The business can be done keeping modus operandi on the either way. Either you can go on concentrating on to the producer way, or you can go on concentrating on to the consumer way. American companies, fortunately or unfortunately, mostly concentrate on consumer way, especially who are big companies. Google has done that. They are big. Take any, Facebook has done that. They are making big. Apple is anyways the best example of using it. McDonald's does that. KFC does that. I mean, the list is endless. This way, to use the tools of doing a better consumerism, social media provides you that. It just not only provides you to churn up into different transactions, it also gives you the advantage of interaction, solving the problem real time. And it have given so much power to the consumerism and the ultimate consumers that they can ultimately destroy you. There was one wrong listing done on Snapdeal a couple of months back, in which the I just forgot the name of the product. It was a small product, but the cost of it, I guess it was hard drive or something like that, but the cost was written as 79 lakhs or something like that, and people have just made a fun of it and destroyed it, and they have to immediately cover it up in an hour's time or 2 hours time. So you also have rapid action teams which are dedicated towards it. So this is like riding a lion. You can't avoid it, and once you're down, it's gonna eat you. So it is very important for me, the communication into digital marketing, especially if it's for a startup or into the 2 years or 3 years of business and still under $100 million, is social media and YouTube promotions. These are the two channels which I always recommend for. This statement was given by one of the bloggers who was writing a book on social media, and he has written that, I was writing a book, I have worked on the research, and over the years of research I found out, I started with writing a book with the name 80 Rules of Social Media, but eventually I came out with the result that there's only one rule, that you have to love your fans, you have to do for your fans. And social media gives you an advantage of doing that. Now, let us see how Facebook potentially utilizes it. As a digital marketer, it gives you an advantage of putting an ad. In that ad, it gives you an advantage of putting a visual, writing down the headline, writing down the name of the brand, writing down the small text of limited letters where you can write down what is your offering and all that. So it gives you a complete package of putting an ad, a template like we have seen, right? So, but if you're choosing any of the objectives, it will only give the end consumer where the ad is shown as a like button. There is no dislike button. There's nothing called dislike into it. So by this, you can only like it or ignore it. And since you want to prompt it to do any action, if you like any ad or any post or anything like that, you just like it. You have no other option to do it. So at the end consumer, you get that fan into your fan base, into your Facebook fan list, and you're just extending it. So it gives you an advantage, a mileage of keeping it into your loop. So Facebook way is of how bullet sign it sounds, it is helping you out some way or the other. So the rule, there's no rule. The rule is only to follow a like button, right? So are we clear till here? All right. Now, what do you think? Facebook, if Facebook start putting a dislike button, will it help the business and eventually will help the digital marketers? For example, you are working for any brand. would you think that it will help you out, or it won't, or let it be like that? Let them only give like button. Any one of you can answer that. Chirag, would you like to answer it? Naveen says there should be a dislike button. I'm not saying think from a customer point of view and consumer point of view. Think from a digital marketer point of view. Let's say, for example, you're working for a shoe brand campaigning and you're working for for any brand for that matter, and you're working as a digital marketer. So if Facebook tomorrow starts putting a dislike button, would your brand eventually, and brands like you and digital marketers like you, would it help or not help? I'm getting the answers. It will help. But how? Supreet is saying it won't help. Chirag is saying how. Can you describe in one line how it will help? Okay, Chirag is saying you can judge the mood that they not like it. But try and understand it. Suppose your objective of a campaign is to put a post and promoting it. Like for example this, I'll take my company's example. Like for example, if woman has an e-commerce site which is offering fashion products into different verticals for women, right? This was the contest, so let us forget that. Now this is the ad, or this is the post which are done. I can go to the ads manager and boost it choosing the objective of boosting this particular post. And if it eventually end up in, I'll check out all the text which I have written chat, but I'll just complete what I'm saying. And if there is one dislike button also, like I said, dislike bhi hai. So ultimately, as a brand manager, it may turn out to be a loss to me, hai na? Kyunki sab dekhenge bhi ki itne sare log dislike bhi kar rahe hain, yaar bekar hai. And even if you as a third customer, let's say for example, Preeti tomorrow likes this dress, want to buy it, but sees on the review, which reading a comment is a different story, but if there are so many dislikes over here, he'll say, nahi yaar, itni badhiya bhi nahi hogi, why are people disliking it, probably stuff acha nahi hoga and all that, and may ignore it, right? So I believe that dislike would eventually be a problem for startups, right? Will help brand, is there more likes than dislike? Yes, Naveen also have a good point that if they'll compare it, and consumer will ultimately compare and will see if there are more likes than dislikes, they'll probably give them positive thing. All right, I'll read one by one what you guys have written. Even if there's a dislike button, it should be seen by the admin and not the public. Yeah, but then it eventually won't help it, because they have to include it in the product itself into the Facebook. So it won't help. I don't think so, that way it will be shown ever, that you'll be able to see as an admin and not as a public. Preeti, maybe it would help in a way that will know what's working, what's not. In yes, but it will give a negative. Yes. So you are saying that will be a learning experience and you know that this is not working. But Preeti, I have point, which is like, for this post, you may have an impression of, let's say, 2000 people, and you have reached to the 2000 people, and I'm getting more dislikes, but it may eventually not be a good sample also. There can be another 10,000 people, which if I continue promoting a campaign, promoting this very particular they may like it further going down running with the campaign. So just picking up a small sample of 200-300 people and see that there are many dislikes, I'll try to change the creative strategy or the media strategy of putting an ad at different times and all that. I may eventually will not get a good result. So I may get prompted of doing an action, a recorrection at a very early stage where it is not required, right? Chirag is saying, yes sir, the people will compare the counts of like and dislike button and then judge. Yes, it will eventually happen, and that is the reason. More so, since initially when Facebook have launched into different countries, they do not have this ad manager kind of thing. As a digital marketing, like for example in Twitter, you cannot put a paid ad. There is no way of doing it. It is not running. It is there in US, but not in India. They have not still launched it. So Facebook earlier has also done that. They're creating their database, they're creating their product at the end of the day. And once they've done that, they haven't put any dislike button. So they only put like button. And then they, from last few years, they've opened it for the digital marketers, and it is working as a revenue model for them. Now they're more inclined to not put a dislike button, because earlier the only party which may get hampered the Facebook branding is from the side of consumers. Now since they are making revenues from the small digital marketers like you and me, they do not want even us to get pissed off now. So I see a less possibility of putting a dislike button. Even if they do, there will be a bold step, because they will be getting pressure from both the sides, not only from the consumer side who may not like an option or dislike or may give a negative publicity to Facebook, but at the other side, they will also start getting pressure from digital marketers like us. Because if I'll be getting more, I'll tell you what you do. You would not waste your time in changing your strategy in Facebook promotions. If you're getting more dislike on Facebook promotions for your campaigns, what you do is you forgive Facebook. Aap kuch aur promote karoge, Facebook mein promote hi nahi karoge. You are not going to waste your energy in redesigning the ad, working on the strategy of how to get a better Facebook ad. You will eventually dump off, and it will be a direct loss to Facebook and to you as well in long run, right? So are we clear till here? Ali, Inkesh, all right. Any questions so far? I guess we should start with the dry run and then keep on discussing in between now, right? All right. So anyways, we are on the first thing required in this is you have to make your brand's Facebook page. Like for example, you made it for Womania, but you can only do it from your Facebook account. You may be the admin or the one who has been granted the right to do a little editing. So first you have to do is go to the ads manager. You have to go to Ads Manager. And this is the dashboard of Ad Manager. And then you have to click on Create Ad. And Facebook, like any other good digital brand, keep on changing their look and feel. Of the product, so they have changed the look and feel of Ads Manager as well. Earlier it was a little different. There was no this window on the left hand side and all that. Anyways, so right now you are on a stage of choosing the objective. The first thing it will ask you to choose the objectives. So different objectives. You can boost your post. At the initial exercise is to boost your post, and this is highly recommendable. The more you, as in the social media domain, and especially in Facebook, as a brand, if you are a B2C brand, a business to consumer brand. Actually, I'll answer you. I'll complete that and I'll answer you. There is idea of continuous engagement. So you just continuously keep on promoting something or the other which may interest your prospective customer and to the loyal fan base. So putting a regular post will help you, and boosting it across will also help you. And there are different you may as a objective may like to concentrate more on page likes. So you're promoting your page, you are sending people to your website, there you'll get the chance to display a little visual, write down a little text, and they can just go into your website by clicking onto it, onto the ad, increase conversion and all that. All right, only saying it has lost the connection. All right, so we're just discussing that. Is the connection okay with everybody else? All right, so there may be a little networking issues onto the certain endpoints. Yeah, and all these. All right, so you choose your, I'll complete the objective page, Ashala, and then I'll try to read and answer your question. Let's say, for example, you're promoting your page. So here it will come as your page, campaign name, how many your page likes, let's say December, and then you move on to the next thing, which is setting the audience and budget. All right, since the objective stage is okay, I'll try to answer Achalata. Would you discuss different strategies to increase likes? I mean, which likes? Ashrata is asking paid likes or post likes. Which likes you are saying? Okay. For FB likes is okay. But let's say, let's take both. Let's take paid like as well as this. The first, there can be two strategies. First strategy is to concentrate more on likes in the initial basis. Like for example, what we are doing it. So we can run down a good aggressive campaign. And once we complete all the modules, on first we have only chose the objectives. On the second, we'll try to filter it down to the specific, so that there are high chances of people with like-minded interest into your brand keep on clicking it. And there will be a very less wastage. Like for example, if I'm very, very specific towards choosing the TG, which is target audience, target group audience, and putting an optimal budget and trying to reach to those people who I think are into a specific group and will be more inclined towards me as a brand, then I'm giving a high probability of likes compared to the wastage of getting the ad, to see the ad and not liking it. So that is the first strategy which you have to follow, that you have to be very, 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 very optimal on towards the TG. Second, do not go a broad-based TG, specifically on geographical areas. For example, over here you can choose the location, right? So if you try to cover the whole country at one base, then you will get a very scattered and thin base campaign. So your ad may land up to me where I may not, or eventually will never turn out to be a good customer or a loyal fan base to you. So I may not like it. So I'll ignore it. And you have to pay to give an impression, a Facebook impression ad to me. So try to be very specific. Not in terms of only the age group and the gender, but try to be very, very specific towards even in the Facebook promotion, try to be very, very specific to the location. This is something which I always recommend. Even if you're getting a slow response, like for example, on the first page, only try to concentrate on, let's say, one city or two or one state, let's say Delhi or Maharashtra or city wise, like Bangalore, Mumbai and all that. So try to be very, very specific onto what you feel is the best location wise. So the first point is that be specific. The second point is be very, very specific towards the TG, especially in terms of locations. Yes, even if you have online store, then you have to do a little R&D offline, where you have to find it out that from where you're getting a good response onto the specific product you're offering online. So what, like for example, if you're into shoes and you're selling online shoes, so you can just try to read it through secondary research, because primary research will be very, very expensive. So do a little secondary research and try to find out from where the other online shoe sellers are getting their response. So is it, and what is your product offering? If your product offering is for the tier one, then which cities are you getting? Like, I'll give you an example. In terms of watches, in terms of, not shoes, basically in terms of watches and in terms of beauty oriented products, you'll be surprised to know that even in shoes, I guess, I'm not very sure about shoes, but even in shoes, I guess, and sunglasses and all that, the maximum risk, and up to some extent, the artificial jewelry. In that case, in India, the best response in terms of transaction, number of transactions you're getting from Northeast, not from Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore and all that. So you're getting good response from Northeast, and Northeast is a very, very difficult logistic market in e-commerce in India. If anybody of you is servicing email e-commerce in India, must be knowing that logistic in Northeast is a difficult task and it's very expensive. If I can put up a normal 500 gram package in Bangalore in less than 50 rupees, I have to pay somewhere around 120-130 rupees to deliver the same package in Northeast. So it is expensive and there is a time delay. But even then, you're getting a very, very good response from them. So if my objective is the end transaction, and I as a digital marketer believe that theek hai, meko Facebook like bhi Northeast se bahut zyada mil jayenge, so let's concentrate over there. If I'm not saying that this is the end result, what I'm saying is you have to just do a little brainstorming and try to find out, even if it's an online store, it should not be at a national carpet. Should never be a national carpet. It should be very specific. Yeah, Ashalata, what the answer? Anybody else? Are we clear till here? Harleen, Chirag, Chitranchi, Aman. All right, so let's choose the location. Then you can go over here and choose the locations. So you can include, let's say, Bangalore. You can choose specific cities. I'm just taking a hypothetical example. You may have Mumbai, Delhi. Yeah. So that way you can choose it. Again, you can now choose age. Age also depends on your product offering. If you are an adult based product, then you should start it with around 20, 21, 22, something like that. If yours is a youth oriented, you should start with 14, 15, 16. If it's for the old age and senior citizens, you should start with 40, 45. So let's say we are starting with 16, going up to 40, 45. You can either choose a common gender, all regular gender, or you can choose a gender as only men specific or women specific. For example, I'm only choosing women specific. And then you can come into the interest category. And there is a famous journal written in marketing by Mr. Leavitt many years back, where is written that there is a tendency of marketers to think myopic. So you should always try to think unmyopic. And there are few modules where this thing helps. Now, what is myopic and unmyopic? I'll try to answer. What do you think, friends, is the best, who is the most good competition in nowadays with so many MNCs, foreign brands coming, is to an Indian watchmaker brand. Let's say, for example, Titan. Biggest competitor Titan ka kya hai? Usko sabse zyada kisse fight karna chahiye? कौन से ब्रांड के साथ इज द बिगेस्ट ट्राई टू आंसर फ्रेंड्स सोनाटा बट देर आर मेनी इंटरनेशनल प्लेयर्स ऑल्सो ना नाउ डेज फास्ट ट्रैक रोलेक्स फास्ट ट्रैक टी शॉट सो अकॉर्डिंग टू यूर टी शॉट फास्ट ट्रैक सोनाटा प्रोबेबली फॉसिल कैसियो अकॉर्डिंग टू ऑल यू गाइस आशला था Preeti, your answer, Naveen, Kamal, Arleen, Chitranshi, please answer. According to you, Rico, according to you, these are the biggest competitor of the watch brand Titan, Rolex. For all those who haven't answered, please answer. Subreet. Timex is the brand of Titan only, I guess. HMT तो हो गया उसका तो काम बट एनी वेज नन ऑफ यू आई एम सरप्राइज नन ऑफ यू हैव सेड आईफोन नन ऑफ यू हैव सेड Xiaomi नन ऑफ यू हैव सेड Samsung मोबाइल फोन्स दिस इज देयर बिगेस्ट कॉम्पिटिटर एंड दिस इज एवरीबडीज बिगेस्ट कॉम्पिटिटर जितने भी आपने नाम लिए इन सब के लिए इनका बिगेस्ट थ्रेट अब इमीडिएट कंपटीशन जो है वो सिर्फ वॉच नहीं रह गया है दूसरा इन सब के लिए सबसे बड़ा कंपटीशन है मोबाइल फोन चिराग इज नॉट गेटिंग द बिगेस्ट कंपटीटर इज मोबाइल फोन फ्रॉम देम बिकॉज यू मे नॉट इवन वांट टू हैव अ वॉच नाउ यस सो दिस इज आवर This is our tendency thinking. You are prospective digital marketers of tomorrow. Yes, digital watch by index. Anything which is not to the contemporary boundaries of product offering. मैं shoes बना रहा हूँ तो मेरा मैं अगर DTC के लिए सबसे बड़ा threat Delhi Metro है. Private buses नहीं है. So try and understand. And this is I really want all you guys to think as a digital marketer in any action you do. Try to do out of the box. Stretch your boundaries in thinking. And this is how choosing an interest over here, which may sound a very common thing, ki agar main travel business mein hu to mujhe travel choose karna hai. Main agar e-commerce mein fashion oriented business mein hu to mujhe shopping wala section choose karna hai. No. There can be a report where you can find that there are mostly from an age group of 20 to 30, the people who like to eat more outside fast food are more shopping crazy as well. And if the response is more than 50%, then try to choose even the people who have interest in eating good food outside. Not limit yourself only onto the fashion brand if you are offering fashion online. Right? Are you getting what connection I'm trying to make here? Right? So even if you are a So if you're selling, let's say, leather jackets, so you should not only go towards choosing the people who have interest in shopping, you should go with people who have interest in body piercing, because it lies onto the same bracket, onto the same group. I'm just taking hypothetical example. I may be wrong in some examples, but yeah. Trending people, we must, you try to use it over here, right? So use accordingly. Use this module accordingly. Choose the behavior and interest into the wisdom of who may like it, even if it is not making a direct connection. Right? So you can choose travel, you can choose anything. In travel also, you can further go down to the basic business travel or the frequent travelers or the people who are currently onto the traveling mode. So you can choose that. So you can choose anything like that, right? So are we clear what I was saying? Any doubt till here? Everybody clear till here? Preeti, Supreet, Mukesh, Arlene, Anil. Yeah? Alright, so moving further. When you have chosen the objective of page likes in the initial out of those 10 objectives, then it is better that you should, into the connections option, you should keep excluding people who have already liked your page, because they are already into your Facebook fan base. So why to waste your money into sending them again? So exclude them over here. And if in case it's a different objective, then you should include everyone. And then budgets. You may put a daily budget, or you may put a overall campaign budget. Lifetime budget doesn't mean lifetime. It basically means the campaign duration lifetime. So if a campaign is for 4 days, then it will have 4 days budget. Or if it's for 10 days, then it will have 10 days budget. It is for a month, it will have monthly budget. You can just put it across. Let's have 250 rupees as a daily budget, right? So run my ads on the continuous today, or you can schedule it like we discussed on the email and we are discussing on the YouTube. You can choose a start date and end date sitting over here. Let's say, for example, you want to choose start date, you want to do an ad for New Year, so you want to do it on 30th, and then you want to end on 1st, right? So since you have put 250 as a daily budget, it will run for 2 days, or total spend will be 500 rupees. And this is on the right hand side, you can see that it will give you an estimate of how many people you can reach. So it is estimating you to reach somewhere around 3,500 people out of the whole target index which you have chosen, on terms of interest, gender and all that. Out of 120,000 people which can be a potential target of what you have chosen in terms of interest, and filtered down in terms of TG, in terms of gender and age and all that, locations, out of that 120,000 prospect, spending 500 rupees for 2 days, you'll be able to reach to this 1300 to 3500 group of audience. And you want to reach more, so you have to spend more. And let's say then you have to spend 500, or let's say 2,500 rupees. And see, now it has changed to 8,300 to 2,200 people. And it is in terms of impression. And then once you keep on doing it a dry run, you'll get the idea ki mereko eventually kitne page likes milte hain. Total Facebook impressions karne se. You can see it on the report as well, but you'll only get with more and more practice. Just because only choosing these attributes will not help. Kya product offering hai, kab ja raha hai, kab kitne connections aa rahe hai. So you'll understand once you do with different brands, different positioning, different choosing different audience and all that. But you'll get the general idea. What will work, what will not work, and how much it will work, right? Are we here till we got it? All of you are understanding till here? Yeah. Now optimization for ad delivery, of course it's going to be paid like with children as an objective for paid like only. So they optimize the ad based on what objective you have chosen, and let them do this job. I mean, their algorithms are very, 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 very good, very, very specific towards giving you the best output. Bid amount is up to you. You want to keep it, like for example, you have put a daily budget of, you put 2500 rupees as a daily budget. So you want every time the bid goes for the ad, you want Facebook to do it automatically, or you want to do it manual. Initially try to do it automatically, because eventually you'll see that there is always a downgoing pattern. In the starting, it will be reaching few people, and out of those few people, only limited people will be clicking onto your ad. So you will be paying with this target audience, you will be approximately paying, let's say, 7-8 rupees per like, then 5 rupees per like, because there will be more people reaching and there will be more likes coming. The ratio will change towards the impression made and the people liking it. And eventually it will turn out to 1 rupee, 1.5 rupee, 2 rupee, or anything between 60-70 paisa to 1-1.5 rupee. With the ad, a little experience I have on to choosing this kind of set audience and all that, and this type of product and this type of creative ad which I made. So once you do it, you'll get the idea. Run in the starting, run few automatic ads. Do not go with the manual bidding right from the starting. Try to read the pattern, try to read the graph of how it goes, and then you get the idea of how much you should bid in manual, right? So it's okay. Everybody understood till here? So you will be charged based on impressions and all that, ad scheduling if in case you want to do that and all that and all that. Alright, so we have chosen the objective. We have also set the audience, specific group and all that. We have put the monies. What is left now? No answer. Ad. Chirag wants to say the creative part of it. So we now have to choose the creative. All right. By creative, I have already informed all you guys what in marketing language, what is the difference between a media and a creative. But for all those who may not know it, everybody knows what is in marketing language is what. Marketing language, what is media and creative? Chirag doesn't know that. Anybody else who doesn't know that, and who knows? Asharada, you must be knowing. I guess we have discussed on the first session. One, when I have shown the slide of Spider-Man, do you remember? Chitranshi knows that. Mukesh doesn't know that. Yes, it is the difference between accountant and financier is for that slide is for Ashlata for digital marketer. As a digital marketer, I want you to be a financier, not an accountant. As a financier, you understand. As an accountant, you will be only limited to of running a tool. Yeah, debit hota hai, credit hota hai, isme se itne paise katenge to itne bachenge. But as a financier, you not only knows that you use your brains of putting a good action and getting a good result, right? And for this thing, media and creative, let us see. First, I'll give you an offline example, and then I'll give you an online example. Name any brand which you guys are obsessed with. Name any brand. iPhone. Entire. Alright. Everybody can see this, right? Touching is believing. This is the ad. For example, this ad have come on today's TOI Times of India newspaper, right? And it was in quarter of a page corner ad. So this you can see that this is the creative. In marketing language, there are two things into it. A, it has to have a host. It has to have a place where it is printed. Even if it's a digital or Apple of you, or you see ad on a TV, or you listen a jingle on a radio, or you go to a mall and you see a promotion going over there inside the mall for a day or over a weekend or all that. Now, you need to have a host. You need to have a place where the ad comes. Over here, what we're discussing, Facebook is a host, is a media. So that is called a media over which, and the ad which you display, the creative part of it, like a shot of a hand, a phone with a bright lighting over there, a text and a logo over here, a text, a copy written over here, texting is believing, the black background, the white color, the size of this many pixels to this many pixels, or if it's a print ad, this many inches to this many inches. This is called the creative. So as a digital marketer, you need not only think about media, you also have to think about the creative. So are you understanding? Have you guys understood what is creative? So in advertisement, there are two types of agencies. There are creative agencies, there are media agencies. There are creative agencies who only make creatives. वो ये नहीं देखते वो कहाँ पे रिलीज करेंगे कौन वो एक दूसरी एजेंसी है जो मीडिया स्लॉट खरीदती है और देती है इन डिजिटल मार्केटिंग मोस्टली इट्स अ वेरी थिन बेस्ड प्रोडक्ट सो मोस्टली यू फाइंड एजेंसी सर्विसिंग बोथ क्योंकि इधर मीडिया पैटर्न अलग है तो इधर यू हैव अ सेम टीम अंडर द सेम रूफ देर आर फ्यू गाइज आर वर्किंग ऑन क्रिएटिव देर आर फ्यू गाइज आर वर्किंग ऑन मीडिया And for big brands, Bhaskar is saying add me, add Bhaskar, where I should add you? You're already there, no? Bhaskar? All right, so everybody got it? What is creative, what is media in terms of talking about marketing, yeah. All right. I'm getting no answers from others. I'm not getting any answer from Naveen, Preeti, Rishikan, Swarajit, Mukesh, Kamal, Chitranshi, Chirag. Yeah. So everybody clear? Chitranshi have already, anyways, knowing about this. Supreet, yeah. All right. So let's get back into ads manager. So we have done little attributes about the media. हमने Facebook में कौन से target के बाद जाएगा क्या जाएगा वो सब choose कर लिया. अभी now it's our time to choose the creative. For creative you have to work with the creative team and work under guidelines of Facebook promotions. और उसमें से आपको चूज करना होगा जब भी आप चूज करोगे आपको यहाँ पे सजेस्टेड साइजेस मिल जाएंगे उसके बट जस्ट टू गिव यू अ लिटिल आइडिया दिस इज द बेसिक फॉर्मेट एंड इट इज बेटर इफ यू कीप ऑन मेकिंग दीज फॉर्मेट सो इफ योर ऑब्जेक्टिव इज क्लिकिंग वेबसाइट लिंक देन इट इज लाइक 1200 by 628 का इमेज का साइज होना चाहिए पिक्सेल्स का द इमेज रेशियो विल बी दिस फॉर द ऑब्जेक्टिव व्हिच वी हैव चोजन व्हिच इज पेज लाइक्स इट विल बी 1200 by 444 हाँ अच्छा लगता यू विल गेट द इंफॉर्मेशन इनटू दिस दे हेयर ओनली You go and choose the, once you click on from to choose the image, you see over the right hand side will recommend you. It'll recommend you what size it should be there. In digital space, the sizes are in pixels. So it is 1200 by 444 pixels. So whosoever is little familiar with graphic designing, for whatever graphic tool you are using, either Corel Draw, Photoshop or all that, you have an option of making into the specific size or into ratios, right? So you can, the designer can choose, go and choose instead of inches or millimeters, can choose pixels and make an ad into 1200 by 444 pixels, width into height. So it is by width, it is 1200 recommended and height 444 pixels. And the image ratio will be 8:3. What is image ratio? This is, now we are into the creative space. So we're discussing a little about creative, though as a course, it is not, I mean, I should not be teaching too much creative, but never mind. I'll let you know, guys, know about creatives. So what is image ratio? Does we know? Who all knows what is image ratio and who all doesn't know? Preeti doesn't know what is image ratio. All right. Nope. By this, you will not end up in turning yourself a digital marketer. You will also end up in turning yourself a good marketer. Right? All right. So most of us doesn't know that. I'll let you know. Assume that you are a marketer, for which you also have to do digital marketing and all the other marketing channels, for example, print ad and TV ads and all that for a particular brand. Let's say Nestle, Maggie, right? Yeah. Yes, Aman, Kamal. I'll explain you what is image ratio. Yes, Kamal has written pixel length into breadth. That is the answer. But it is not pixel, it is size length into breadth. So image ratio is a terminology which is used in for digital marketers, common language, and talking with the agency. So you are Nestle and let's say Publicis, your creative agency, is making ads for Maggie. So what you communicate with them is कि मेरे को एक कैंपेन करना है, अभी रीलॉन्च हो रही है फेसबुक मैगी, और मुझे डिजिटल में भी लॉन्च करना है. आई ऑल्सो हैव टू लॉन्च इट ऑन आउटडोर एडवर्टीजमेंट, आई ऑल्सो हैव टू लॉन्च इट ऑन प्रिंट, एंड देर इज वन कैंपेन, और एक ही जैसा दिखेगा हर जगह. एंड दिस इज द क्रिएटिव, यू मेक मी अ क्रिएटिव. अब जो डिजाइनर वहां पे बैठा है, जब वो उस क्रिएटिव को बनाएगा, तो क्या वो हर एक के लिए अलग अलग बनाएगा? वो नहीं. क्यों? क्योंकि जब आउटडोर में प्रिंट होगा तो वो बड़े फॉर्मेट पे प्रिंट होगा, उसका साइज होगा 20 फीट बाय 40 फीट. जब यहां के लिए एड बनेगा तो सेम एड का रेशियो होगा 600:300 पिक्सल्स. जब वो प्रिंट में जाएगा तो सेम रेशियो 2:1 की होगी, लेकिन उसका साइज जो होगा वो 12 inches to 6 inches होगा. तो जब भी ग्राफिक डिजाइनिंग में, आई एम स्पीकिंग हिंदी सो दैट you just don't miss anything. When it's gonna make, the graphic designer or the digital marketer is making those ads, will not ask his team to make it the same ad into different sizes. What they will say is कि आप एक ratio बनाओ, जो 2:1 है वो 2:1 ही रहेगा. फिर जब वो print होना होगा तो वो machinery में जब print होगा या जहाँ पे भी display होगा, digital में तो printing involved नहीं होता. But if there is printing in print ads or there is printing in outdoor hoardings and all that, then the same creative have to be printed somewhere. So वो उसी रेशो को पिक करके उसी साइज पे प्रिंट कर लेंगे. So digital marketer creative team वाला member does not have to work on the same size, same ratio and work it multiple times. उसको चार बार काम नहीं करना पड़ेगा. तो एक ही एड बनाएगा जो कि वो सेम लेंथ इनटू ब्रेथ पे कर लेगा. तो फिर इफ द साइज इज 1200 बाय 444, दैट मींस इट इज ऑफ द रेशियो 8:3. तो 111 को अगर आप डिवाइड करोगे तो आपको ये रेशियो मिलेगा. फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ इट इज 400 इनटू 200 पिक्सल्स, देन इट इज अ रेशियो ऑफ 2:1. Right? If it is 600 into 200, then it is ratio of 3:1. So everybody got it? I've also not only let you know about this image ratio thing mechanically, but its use as well, right? So you should not only know how to run the tool of the part of it. This is only 20%. The use is also important, which is 80%, right? Then Facebook as a policy will not allow you to put a text on the image more than 20%. There is reason behind this, because this contains a symmetry and a little hygiene, because Facebook has its end consumer for Facebook. वो Facebook करने आए हैं और Facebook को अपने brand को वो रखना है, तो वो आपको allow नहीं करेगा कि आप कुछ भी कर लो. For to you want to put a little information, so it will allow you to put information as a headline or a text below the image, but in the image it will only allow you to put a 20% of the text over the image. Yes, you are right. It should be 3:1. So I don't know why they have written 8:3. It has to be 9:3 in case they want to write it. नहीं 8:3 तो आएगा, 400:12 होगा ना 3:1 तो. ऋषिकांत, इट विल बी इफ इन केस इट वुड हैव बीन 1200:400, देन इट वुड हैव बीन एग्जैक्ट 3:1, विच इज 9:3. बट सिंस इट्स 1200/444, राइट, देन इट इज 8:3. ऑल राइट, सो दे आर राइट. Anyways, so here you can choose the image. You can add image from going over there and pick it up, or whatever image you want to put. It is already there, so I'm using it. You can browse the image and put it. Ask your designer to make on the specification of this ratio, and it will be shown like this. Then you can, the image comes over here like this. And you can write down your text. So you can write down anything. Romania. The first fashion choice. You can write down anything. So you see, it has come over here. Right? Headline. You want to first put it your brand name, but you can write down anything. So let's say you can write down Romania shopping. I think it has crossed the limit of words, I guess. It is for 25 letters, I suppose. Okay, this will only show on the right hand column. I'm sorry. So it is not showing in the preview over here. But whatever you write down over here will come as a headline. Yes, Chirag is, this is the headline. Landing page is your this. That's it. This is how the ad on the mobile will be shown. So you have a like button, you can just click it. And this is how the desktop right column will be shown. Yes, so here it is the headline, Womania Shopping. Right, but you can just write down only Womania over here. And then you can just place your order. It will go for a review for a time being. It'll check on the if everything is into the review, the payment module is already existing and all that. And then it will start running. It will get approved and it'll start running. If in case it's an onto the current timings, it'll simultaneously start running. And if it is pre-scheduled, like we have scheduled for 31st, it'll run on 31st. So friends, got the answer? Any doubts till here? Yes, so once you use your Facebook, you will see that on the right hand side, the ad will be displayed like this. Wait, I have to click onto this. Wait, I'll go to the edit and show you again. So let's say you are using your Facebook, Achalata, and on the right hand side, you're using it on a desktop, and on the right hand side, you see an ad coming like this. And if you click, you like it, you just click over here, you will be taken to the Facebook page, and it'll you're automatically added as a page like. So you will be counted in. Over here, you will be counted in these likes, and as an when here you will get the notification. If you are the admin of it, you will get the notification that this and this person has added as liked. Like for example, Vipin Chawda likes Womania. So if you are done, I'll receive the notification that Achalata has likes Womania or Aishwarya likes Womania. So I get to know. Achalata, are you clear with the answer? Chirag, and how we have to pay our budget to the FB? For budgets for FB as well as for Google AdWords, how it goes that once you register or make a Facebook page, there is an option of going on to the billing, and there you have to fill your credit card details, and into their terms and conditions you have to fill the details and keep it with them. So what happens is when you run a campaign, after a few days a bill invoice is raised and automatically that amount is deducted from your credit card. It only takes credit card, no debit card. Achalata is asking, FB has paid like options, right? What is it? This is paid like option, what we have discussed. Rishi Khan says, my voice is breaking. So this thing, you can also run not only for your brand, you can boost your page by paying them also at a personal level also. Achalata can hear me, everybody else can hear me.
That could be a little issue with networking over there at your end because everybody else can listen to me. Anto, are we clear? You are not active today. There were no questions. Ashalata is clear. Bhaskar, you have said in between that you want me to add you. Where do you want me to add you? Chirag, are we clear? Chitranchi, Harleen, Kamal, Mukesh, Naveen, Priti. Any questions related to the topic we have discussed or even anything else? You can just ask it. Sarabjit. Alright, and this is the feedback link. I'm answering the question simultaneously, and I'll also request you to take out some time simultaneously till the time we end. And all of you, please fill the feedback form and do write the comments as well. This is very, very important. It just helped me out in great deal once I read the comments and the ratings and how to go about making the session next time. So please write the comments as well. Chitranshi, I need the link today for video that I can go through it again. Yeah, Chitranshi, I'll ask the admin. This uploading of the video is taken care by the main admin. I'm just trainer over here. What I'll do is I'll pass on your communication to them that it should be uploaded today. So I'll do that. Chirag is saying, sir, in between you gave an example related to rupees per like. What is that? I mean, not that. Rupees per like. Chirag, you're asking if I'm getting it right. Yes, sir. In between, you gave an example related to rupees per like. What is RS? Rupees per like, right? Yeah, so it is basically. Alright, I'll give you the. Wait, I'll answer you. So you go to Ads Manager. And this is under preview which we have run, so I'll take an example from the earlier campaign and see if it is showing the results. Unfortunately, I do not have currently in my dashboard this campaign which is showing the results. But what you see over here is, it is not showing it right now, but I'll let you know, Chirag and everybody else. That will show you that how much you have paid per like over here. So per result, it will give you a cost. Like for example, for the campaign which we have run, eventually we have given them 2500 rupees per day to spend. And let's say we get in those 2500 rupees, we get, let's say, 2500 likes. I'm just taking an example. So as a result, our thing will be costing us rupees 1 per reach, per like, right? So this is what I was saying. So it'll give you those results. Guys, I guess you are not filling the response, the feedback and leaving. Why don't you guys just fill and then let me know that you're done and then leave, please. Sarojit is saying, Ashraf, I'll just come to your question first. I'll try to answer Sarojit. Will you please give us one example if you want to post that? For example, you want to post that. Sarojit, in what sense you're asking? I mean, which ad you, I didn't get you. Please give us one for example if you want to post that. This is the ad which you have posted. So you want any specific, for any specific brand, any specific category, and then I'll give you the example. Or where do you want to post it? In Facebook, no? This is how you do it, what we have discussed. Yeah, of course, Ashalata, you can just do that. In fact, I'll also try to help you. You just share the link of your Facebook page, please, with everyone. This is how the marketing happens, that the like-minded people should go about it. Friends, please go to Facebook page of Ashalata's brand and just see to it and like it, in case you like it. Ashalata, I request you to just share the link of the Facebook page. Sarojit, I'll surely like to give you the example. But where do you want to post it? In the Facebook, this is the way which you have discussed. Friends, please fill the feedback form as well and just let me know that you're done with it. Facebook only, this is the way. You first have to choose the objective. You can choose the objective of, making it a page like, or you want to promote your post which you have done. So this is the same way how you make an ad and post it. We have just done that. These are the steps which you have to follow. And since right now it is in the approval stage, once it gets approved, it will start running. And the preview which you have seen, where there was an image, there was text written beneath it and over it, that was of how you make an ad. You put an image, you write down the text below it, you choose the target audience, choose the objective, you put in the money to do that, and you just click on running an ad. Once it gets approved, it will start running and it will be displayed to the audience which you are choosing. And in the dashboard over here, you can see how it goes. Yeah. Guys, are you filling the feedback form? Please do fill the feedback form, write down the comments, and let me know over here that once you are done, that you are. Any more questions? Anything which you guys have a little confusion of getting it? Good, Chirag. Is it your venture? You're linked with this? Okay. So are we clear how we do Facebook promotions? And also, are we clear how we what is the difference between creative and media? Kesh Kamal, Lashalata. Please fill the feedback form and write it down. Pin over here that once you're done. And one more thing, I guess few of you are still confusing me with Nikhil Batla, who is the main admin, the main guy behind Paathshala. Oh, thanks, Chirag. Nikhil Batla is different. I'm Nikhil Grover. I'm only linked with Paathshala as a trainer, so I just take sessions. So sending the links for the meetings or uploading the final videos and all that lies with the main admin, Nikhil Batla. So he does this job. I only come and take the sessions. That's my job. And of course, I'll answer you all your queries relating to it. Friends, I've been asked to add into Facebook page, WhatsApp group as well. So I'll be logging into my WhatsApp. There were some issues into it. In a day or two, I'll just log in and I'll request every one of you to be into one group, and then if in case you have any query, we can just chit chat over there as well. And you're very quiet today. What happened? Left. Bhaskar, you have filled the form. Rishikant has filled. Thanks. All those who have filled can take a leave if in case they do not have any question. Kamal, did you get the email marketing today? I guess you haven't covered in the last session. We'll try to cover it in the coming sessions somehow. Chirag, don't worry about that. So anything you have missed, you can also check out the video for email marketing, the full-fledged video of 2 hours. And if in case even then you have some queries, I'll be happy to take it. No problem. Thanks. And you have filled the form, no? Right. This is the link for the videos. You can just check out all the videos here. Thanks. Vasya, you there? You were saying something that you want me to add into. And how did you get this session? You get it? Nice. Have you filled the form? Yeah, good night. Kamal, you there? All right, friends, time to go. Bye bye. See you next week.